Welcome to the new series on Lambda Test, where we'll be talking about Selenium with C# on NUnit testing framework. In this series, we'll be covering a lot of topics related to what NUnit is and its advantages, setting up NUnit within local machines and running first NUnit test, how we can run an NUnit test along with Selenium on Lambda Test platform, and how we can leverage the power of NUnit parallel execution with Lambda Test platforms. And finally, we're going to perform tunneling to run test on application hosted in the local machine from via Lambda Test platform. So these are the topics that we'll be covering in this series, and we'll see how we can leverage the power of NUnit for our test automation with Lambda Test platform. And in this video, we can talk about NUnit introduction. So what is NUnit testing framework? Well, NUnit is a unit testing framework for all .NET languages. It has support of .NET 5 and the .NET Core framework. NUnit is also extended by other tools to perform tool-specific actions like SpecFlow, for example. If you have used SpecFlow before, you would have seen SpecFlow NUnit is one of the dependencies that you will be adding in your SpecFlow project because it extends its own SpecFlow specific NUnit hooks to run the test. And there are many advantages of having NUnit within your test because NUnit test framework helps to run the test in parallel, sequence, and the order that you specify. So these are the things which are going to be very, very helpful while we try to run any test that we have written. NUnit test can be executed via command line with different parameters which can be used to run the test. And that's exactly what we'll be doing in this series as well, while we try to pass different parameters or environment variable from Lambda test platform to the test that we have written and change or modify the behavior of how the test actually executes. And NUnit actually has many inbuilt attributes as well, and using these attributes, we can decorate a C# method as a test method or as a test fixture or hook, something like that. And NUnit's assertion will help to perform pass fail of a test that we are executing. And this is exactly what is required while we try to run our test on any testing platform and also within our Lambda test platform. And finally, NUnit has got a lot of support with the IDE that we work. For example, in this series, we'll be using Visual Studio and we'll see how NUnit test adapter features allow NUnit to run inside Visual Studio 2019. Well, as that said, the NUnit sample test structure is going to look something like this. It is going to have a class which will be decorated as a test fixture, and it's going to have a setup method. And as you can see within the setup method, we mostly use to set up, for example, Selenium webdriver to invoke a browser, or it can be a database which will be set up to perform a connectivity or opening a file, something like that. And similarly, there will be a teardown method which is going to perform a cleanup operation. And this is going to be like cleaning up our Selenium webdriver or closing the webdriver or disconnecting the database or closing a file and things of that nature. And the actual test itself. As you can see, here is where we are going to perform our actual test. For example, Selenium test to perform a login operation or user detail filling operation or settings operations and things of that nature. And here is where we'll be doing our assertion operations. And all these methods are actually decorated by attributes like setup attributes, test attributes, and teardown attributes. And this is the very, very super simple basic NUnit sample test structure. But if we're gonna have a different fixture level or parameter level within our NUnit test, then the code is gonna look something like this. As you can see, within this test, we have something called as a test fixture with different parameters in it, like Chrome, version of the Chrome, and the operating system like Windows 10, something like that. And because we are passing different parameters, these parameters are consumed within the properties of a class file, something like these. And these properties are then going to be assigning the value based on the order that we have specified within the test fixture, within the properties within the class file. And then these value are going to be used within either the setup method or test method, or even in the teardown method. So this is how we actually use the parameters within the test, and these parameters can also be passed from NUnit console if we would like to run the test from the CLI. And once we execute this test, the output is going to look something like this. As you can see within the test, we actually have the parameter being printed like Chrome, the version 87.0 and Windows 10 as the operating system. So this is how we can actually run a test using test fixtures and different hooks or attributes of NUnit and make use of NUnit framework in different types of tests within our organization. Thank you so much for watching this video. Meet you in our next video where we talk about the NUnit setup and prerequisite.
In case you have any questions or you're requiring further information, you can chat with the team or you can also drop us an email at support@lambdatest.com. We're here to help and we'd love to hear from you. Subscribe to our channel to stay on top of exciting features on your way. Happy testing!